dislocated and it's completely normal, but yeah, I think it's fine. Yeah.
And I like the way how you always try to keep things real, even in terms of you posting your
Thank
pictures
you.
in social media and all that. I mean, like, I don't see a lot of actresses, you know, keeping themselves real. So it really creates an impact. So thank you so much for that
I
as
think
well.
it's all to do with the fact that, thank you for the compliment. I think it's a lot to do with the fact that people are anyway seeing us in different characters when they come to the theater or TV or, you know, so this is the only platform where you can keep yourself really real. And a lot of actors are doing that today. If you know, if you really see a lot of people, they like to keep it real because they're fed up of this makeup and they're fed up of being someone else. So if you're real, you don't have to lie, you know, otherwise you'll have to
It's
keep
easier,
lying.
right?
Yeah, it's easier to be real.
So how is this lockdown treating you? How is this, you know, staying at home? How are you coping up with it? All okay?
Yeah, because you know why? In fact, I've been staying at home since September 2019, last year, that
You
is.
were telling me,
I had a small surgery. Yeah. So at least I can walk around the house. At that point, I couldn't even, you know, get off the bed. I was literally on the bed for like 6 weeks. So I find this a huge blessing that the fact that I can walk around. So that's what I'm saying. Like, for me at that point, it was really frustrating. And, you know, so many thoughts are there. Like, oh my God, you know, you just came out of a leg surgery. Will I be able to walk? Will I be able to dance? Then you see someone dance. You're like, oh my God, I'm like this. All those thoughts, I've crossed that phase. So for me, this is, yeah, this is suffocating because I not able to see my friends. I'm not.
Well, yeah, is your internet fine? Like your voice is breaking in between.
Your voice is breaking. Sorry.
Yeah, your voice is breaking
Can you
in
repeat the
between. So
question?
is your internet fine?
Yeah, now I can hear you.
Yeah, okay, cool. So, so my next question is, there's a lot of news around in terms of coronavirus, right? So there's a lot of positive as well as negative news going around. So sometimes it's a bit too overwhelming. And again, when we, like today, when I read the news that there's another 2 week extension, it actually gets to your head, like, you know, when your routine is all
A little
distorted.
bit, yeah.
Yeah. So how are
Yeah.
you taking it? And is there any specific news that has created an impact during this period? It can be positive or negative.
To this thing, no positive and negative, it's our perspective. If you want to see something in a positive way, you can. But if you want to see the same thing in a negative way, I think you can do that as well. But yes, of course, the positive things are I can just sleep all day. I can watch a lot of movies and reading books and catching up with my old friends from school and college, which I haven't done in a long time. And we've always, like, especially when you take us, we've always in front of people, right? So this is the time when we can, you know, do our own things. But when you see things around you, it is a bit overwhelming because you see a lot of people without food. You see a lot of people struggling to get that. So that's what I'm saying. So I am blessed because I get my 3 meals. I have a roof above me and I consider that as a huge blessing. So that is the only thing that makes me a little upset when I see people around me, especially people who are working from morning to evening to give us groceries. And then you see the doctors and hospital people, the cops, the government. So they're working 24/7 to make things better for us. So in the beginning, honestly, all this never crossed my mind. I was very, very frustrated. I was like, I didn't even know what corona was. I didn't know what it's going to do. And then I watched a movie, then I realized, okay, this is what is going to happen soon in our country. Then you get an idea. Then you get a bit, you know, you get a little angry when you see, okay, you have to sit at home for like 2 weeks or 3 weeks. You didn't know what a lockdown was, you know, until this happened. So a lot of things in the beginning, but now this has become a lifestyle if you think about it. Everybody's like, oh, extend by 2 weeks? Okay, cool. Okay, we'll see what we can do in that 2 weeks. You know, you're used to this lifestyle. But the only thing that's really worrying me is the fact that the cases in Chennai are going up, which is a bit scary. But then when you think about those people who are working, for you, and the only thing you can do is pray for them and, you know, stay at home. That's very important.
Lovely. So, you say like being grateful change everything, right?
I think that's very, very important, Pooja. I think being grateful is one of the most important thing. That's something that my father has taught me. Only if you, I wasn't like this. I might be talking like you're being grateful is good and all of that. I wasn't like this before, but I think your experiences teach you a lot, especially after going through a leg surgery. And then when you sit here today, when you're able to walk 2 steps of, I still can't jump with full force. So if I can jump a little bit, I'm happy. So those little experiences teach us a lot. And I'm sure after the lockdown is done, and which I'm pretty sure all this is going to get over soon. So once that is done, I'm sure a lot of people will learn what gratefulness is, and they will try to be happy for more small things. Yeah,
I mean, I agree with what you said, like, you know, experiences teach us a lot. And I think this coronavirus, this COVID-19 experience, the best that we have to feel grateful for little things that we have, right? So, yeah.
Little things matter, something that it taught us.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's nice to see less pollution outside, and nice to see a lot of birds you know, and dogs and cats just walking around freely. Yeah. So, somewhere it is good to see, but
there are, like,
obviously,
so
you don't
different
want
different kinds of birds that you see on terrace, right? I had no idea that existed in Chennai. Yeah,
exactly. Same thing. So, when I see news and all, I'll be like, what? This was there. So, but the only thing, like I said, is I don't want so many people to die, I don't want so many people to fall sick. You know, it's not nice. So, I hope all this they find a solution and we get out of this soon.
Yes, true. Okay. So, we're jumping into the very important question that I wanted to ask you, and you were agreeing to talk about it. No, I mean, that's the most important core of this live session, right? Yeah. So, I was happy when you agreed to talk to me about a mental issue that you were going through. So, would you like to brief us about it? You had a struggle with anxiety, right?
Yeah, I still do at times. It's not done. Okay. But like I said, I'm used to it. Now I know what to do. So
how did you figure out that you were going through anxiety, and how did you get help? So I want you to just run us through the whole process so that people have an idea.
Okay, I don't want to scare anybody, or I don't want to look like I'm going to narrate a story. But this happened.
Yeah,
I mean, okay, I'm not proud to talk about it either, but it's important that people know about it.
Yes.
It happened to me in 2017. Till then, I think I probably would have had it before, but I didn't know about it. So I was supposed to take off for a shoot to Paris, to France. This is a place called Nice. Okay, so I was supposed to go there for 30 days, 30 to 35 days of shoot continuously. And I haven't done that before. You know, our normal shoots are like 20 days and or 15 days, and then you get a scheduled break. So you're so used to taking the break, go visit your family or your friends, you know, being around them. That was my lifestyle. I never signed any projects back to back. I always would take that little break in between. So, and then this happened, and then they said I have to, be in France for 1 month. And I was actually a little excited. I was like, wow, there's a beautiful place to be, right? For 1 month, you can do whatever you want and you can just be happy, and such a beautiful country. So I was really, really happy. But then slowly, as I was like, if I was supposed to take off on think October or November 1st, around October mid, I started to have this weird feeling. Like I would wake up from my sleep, or I would just wake up and start crying. I don't know for what. Or I wasn't hungry. I didn't want to meet my friends. I was a very social person. I used to go out a lot, so I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to talk to my parents, and I am someone who will call my dad at least 4 or 5 times a day, you know, and I didn't want to do that. That would be just once or twice. And the moment I hear his voice, I want to cry. But I was too scared to tell them that I was going through something like this, because I myself couldn't figure it out, right? Then, I did talk to a few of my friends, and they said it's nothing. It's, I think, probably because you're going to miss us and you know, going to take off for a month, so you're going to miss your family, maybe because of that. But I'm not that kind of a person. You know, in Stella, how hostelites are, right? When you're there, you get to go home once in 4 months or 3 months, unless it's an emergency. You are in your hostel, full stop. Like, you have to finish the semester and go. So, I've been through it. So, this is nothing like that. So I had a doubt. So I started like watching a few videos and stuff where people did talk about anxiety and stuff. But even then, I didn't get any clarity. And I reached out to someone. And she was the first person who told me that you're going through anxiety. I had absolutely no clue what anxiety was. And I didn't like what I was feeling. I don't like to cry all the time. So the moment you wake up, I always, you know, things that I hate doing when the moment I wake up is listen to someone complaining or whining or seeing a negative message. I don't like all these things. So for a person like that, waking up and crying was, I don't know, it was a huge change for me. So, and I was also getting scared because the shoot dates are coming closer, right? So I don't know if I'll be able to perform. I don't know if I'll be able to do this. I was really confused, but I obviously have to take off the shoot because you, that's your commitment. So I went there thinking a change of place would be good. So I went there. It was even worse there. You know, I used to cry every day. And there you don't have many people around you except your team. And I called up my producer, Parul, and I spoke to her and said, I'm going through something like this. And she was really helpful. And I think they discussed within the team and the director got to know. And they understood I'm going through something like this. But they couldn't take any help there because we are somewhere else. We don't know anybody there. So I had to put up with that for a month. But I think I survived. And my work kept me busy. And when I come back, I try to call someone and talk to someone so that till I sleep, I don't feel that suffocation. You feel suffocated. You feel like it's difficult to breathe and you don't want to look out. You feel like, you know, you want to run away from it. You know, and then you're like, what will happen next? What will happen next? If I do this, it's always a curiosity, too much curiosity. Okay? So that was happening. When I came back, it disappeared. It was like I was fine when I came back. And then I thought, that's it. It's just a phase. But again, when my leg problem happened, when the surgery happened, it came back again. So then I had to go meet someone professional and he said that you're going through this and it'll keep coming. There are different ways to get over it. I got over it by, honestly, I cried a lot. I spoke to a couple of my friends who knew me really well, who would understand me rather than just say, you know, you're just sad, you'll be fine in like a couple of hours, you know. And I watched so many videos of so many people talk about this and I understood it's not just one person. A lot of people go through it. So it's okay to go through it. Just, you know, snap out of it. If it's if that's difficult, then you consult someone and you take help. Just like you have a headache, you call up a doctor. You have fever, you call up a doctor. It's the same thing. So when I started seeing that as a normal thing, my life changed. I did speak to a lot of people from our industry and a couple of them did mentioned that even they've been through something like that. So I think I understood it's very common. It's not nice to have it, but it's something's very common and you just have to accept it and move on.
I mean, like a lot of virtual hugs to you from here. And, you know, I'm so happy and glad that you are like, it takes a lot of courage to actually share a story like this out in public, you know. I'm sure this is
no, but that's the thing, right? You don't have to see it as public. I'm also a human being. I'm also a normal person. My job is to act, but if my job is done, I'm just as normal as you are or anybody. So it's okay to talk about it and it's okay to discuss it because how long are you going to run away from it? Now, if you see everybody's talking about
even for like a normal person, right? I don't think everyone's willing to actually open up because of the fear of judgments that they might face or the fear of comments that they might get. Like you said, you know, none of your friends luckily didn't say that, you know, it's okay, you're just feeling sad, we'll be all right. Because when you are actually going, so I've been in depression, so I kind of can relate to what you have been through. And again, I had a good support system and I went to therapy.
Support system.
Yeah, and that's the reason I started One Life, because when I slowly started talking about it, I can see a lot of people encouraging me to have the conversation, but they are not like, you know, a bit hesitant to talk about what they are going through. And they'd be like, no, you know, I'm from this family. So, you know, if I talk about this, they might judge me or, you know, the name will go down and things
like that. I think people are like, you're absolutely right. People are really scared of judgment, not just when it comes to mental health, generally, most of them. Yeah. But if you see, off late, I see a lot of people talking about a lot of stuff. They stand up for themselves. I think that's very important.
Yeah.
And the more you talk, and the more you talk to people who you trust, it gets really better, actually. If there's someone who can listen to you. I mean, There are people who, if I cry, you know, they'll be like, okay, cry, it's fine. It's absolutely normal to cry. Instead of saying, why are you crying? There's nothing to guys. It's such a silly matter. I just hate when people use that word. It's not silly because you're not able to explain the fact that, you know, what's happening within you. So someone comes and tells you it's silly. You don't have to cry for such silly things. It just becomes worse. So I think it's better to...
If there's something you go through physically, you can actually get it checked and understand how severe it is. But in terms of mental health, you won't even be able to voice out how much it's creating an impact on you and how hard it is for you to... So it's hard for us to express. So, yeah, that's so important that when someone opens up, people can at least just sit quiet and listen. They don't have to always be there to advise you. I mean, just giving a hug...
They don't have to give us a solution.
So just giving a hug means so much, right? When you just randomly cry or when they have no idea what you are going through, they can just say it's okay. Yeah. I mean, that creates so much positivity for a person who's going through it, right?
But Pooja, now things are changing. People know more about mental health. People now know what... Just because there was... Okay, so in between there was this confusion if someone's actually depressed or they're sad because of something. There's always... It's a fine line. Some people, they're sad for 1 hour, they think they're depressed. And, you know, after my whole phase of facing anxiety and stuff, when someone comes and tells me, I'm depressed, man, I'm like, what are you depressed for? It's a huge word that you're using. That only a person who's been through it can talk about it like that. Otherwise, you don't know. You're just like, yeah, even I'm depressed. Like, you know, they full stop. So I think the more people talk about it, the more people... see it, the more people get to hear about it, things will definitely change for sure.
So I actually started One Life last year around September, and from then, and during like this new year especially, right, when people posted a lot about the resolutions that they take, I kind of found like 90% of people put in mental health as one of the resolutions they had. I mean, this didn't happen the previous years. So, yes, there's a lot of difference. There's a lot of change. But I think there's a long way for us to go in terms of having a conversation, reaching out for help. There is not enough medical support actually in our country, even if everyone decides to reach out for help. So there's a lot of work behind it has to happen. But then, yeah, it's good that we're moving towards a positive
It is happening. We just have to give it some time to, like you said, my dad always used to tell me this. There's nothing like happiness, you know. Obviously you need money, you need food, you need your people around, you need family, but there's nothing like mental peace and happiness. And I never understood the meaning of it until I went through it, because by then I had enough money to live, and I was like, you know, I can go out and, you know, just be with my friends and just be out all day, but why am I sitting at home? It's a different feeling. You can't even explain how you feel, because it's very strange. Like, you feel suffocated. You feel like you want to cry for everything. You know, you see a movie. I generally cry if there's a sad thing. Plus, if you're going through this, then you sit and cry the whole day. So, it's difficult for certain people to understand. But like you said, if you have a good support system, or if you're willing to take that extra step of going and meeting someone, I think that itself is like a great thing to do.
Very true. So my next question for you is, so you being out there in public, or anyone in general, you know, any actresses or any media personalities or anyone. So whatever you post on social media, there's always good as well as a bad comment coming behind without even you know. So you post a picture or you try to say something out there, but there are like, totally irrelevant comments. So initial stages, it must have been hard for you to read those comments and all that, right? It can be cyberbullying. It can be a lot of, you know, fake accounts, people creating fake accounts and commenting unnecessary things, right? So how did you deal with it?
In the beginning, it was really tough. I'm not lying about it. I don't want to lie, but it is very tough to see someone talk ill about you. And especially when it comes to your body and stuff. So that really was a bit annoying, frustrating and sad. But, you know, being a public figure, there are so many good things about it. So if there's a good side to it, then there's definitely a bad side to it as well. So you're out there, you're enjoying the attention you're getting. You're doing crazy work. You can do different characters. You meet a lot of wonderful people. And then the other side of it is that you have to go through the comments, and you can't really tell people, don't do this, don't comment like that, you know, don't talk to me like that, because it's their freedom to talk, right? You can't really say don't. So I think the best, you can't really go out and control and change everyone. So what you can do is change how you react. That's the only thing you can do. In the beginning, yes, it is a little sad, but then you can decide not to get sad for such small things also, right? Like I said, after what I went through, it was easier for me to sort of ignore such comments, because I was like, listen, I'm going through something even big, so this doesn't really matter to me. So that is okay. If it's their right to talk about you like that, then it's your right to ignore it. So I think it's very simple. It's a balance. But there are times when I really get annoyed because they say really bad things, and that's the only time I react. But other than that, I try to ignore.
Good, amazing. So my next question for you is, a lot of people do photo shoots and a lot of people post, you know, for the magazine cover and all that, right? So this was actually a question that was asked to makeup artist Samantha Jagan in our March 8th Women's Day event as well. So a lot of youngsters get influenced by the pictures that heroines or actresses post on social media, and they, you know, body shame themselves and feel sad about the way they look, right? So what do you think about? So can you just talk about what happens behind for a person to look like that in front of the camera?
I'm sure Samantha would have answered that question. She'll know it better than anybody else. Even I watch a lot of photo shoots. I like to watch. I like to see pretty girls. I mean, it's nice to see them dressed up.
I'm not saying it's bad.
It's not bad.
Yeah, it's the profession of model or actresses to, you know, look good that way. But sitting behind the screen, when youngsters look at that and get influenced and start body shaming themselves, because in one of the events we conducted for body shaming, most of the people said that, you know, I always wanted to look like so-and-so person. She looks so tall. She looks so beautiful. She looks so fair. She has a long hair. Everything is, all that ideas come to them because of the social media influence they have. So I just want to address this issue of what happens behind or what is real. You don't have to tell us what happens exactly behind, but, you know, what is real?
No magic happens.
Yeah.
To be honest, nothing miracle happens there. When we decide to do a photo shoot, first of all, we don't wake up like that, like how you see us on magazine cover. Okay, we wake up like a normal human being. I have dark circles. I have my hair, man, at times it's let's not even get there. It's like that. So we don't wake up like this. So when we prepare for a photo shoot, there will be a brilliant photographer, okay, who knows all sorts of editing because he's learned all of that. Then we have a really, really good makeup artist who knows what to do on our face according to our skin color, skin tone, and our features. Then we have people who are helping with light so that we look really, really nice. And after all of this, and then we obviously have our stylist who will make us look thin or however. Like I was very conscious. If I'm talking to a stylist, I'll just tell her what I'm comfortable with, what I'm not comfortable with, so that she style the costumes accordingly. So then we have people like that. So it's a teamwork. Okay. And it's like you do the photo shoot and you don't just release the pictures like that. Then it goes through another set of process. Like, you know, pick the best ones, edit it and make it like nice and all of that. So there's a lot of things that go with it. So I want people to understand that it's, first of all, you need to love yourself. You need to love the way you look. It is important to be healthy. It is important to keep yourself fit, but not by starving or not by seeing some actress and be like, okay, I want to be like her. If she's like that, then she's been through her problems. We don't know what that person's been, right?
Yeah.
So, for example, I look up to Alia Bhatt, I look up to Deepika Padukone. Even I want to be like them. I want to look like them. But I know it takes a lot. They work really, really hard because that is a job, right? So you can't, it's impossible to look like someone else, or it's impossible to be like someone else. I think it's very important to sort of know what your identity is, what you're good at, And you know, it's important to love yourself so that you can be confident. So when you're confident yourself, then you don't want to be like someone. Even I've been through a phase where I want to look like so many people. I want to dress up like so many people. Then I started being comfortable wearing, you know, these kind of clothes and going out. Then people start telling me you're an actress, you can't dress up like this. And I'm like, no, it's fine. It's completely fine because I'm comfortable in it. I'm comfortable with this. So why should I hide behind something? Right? Or why should I try to be something? Try to be your best version. That's the only thing you can do. And there's nothing wrong with that.
That's amazing. So you were talking about loving yourself and being self-confident, right? So I agree with you. Yeah. Like, it's very important to, you know, love yourself. So what are the things you do to stay connected to your inner self?
Being myself. I think that's the best way to stay connected to yourself.
Amazing, yeah.
You know? Like you said, I want to keep it real. I have people around me who are also like being themselves. That is very, very easy for me to be like that. And I actually started reading about all these things, about positivity and, you know, what to talk to yourself when you're, you know, alone, and books like that. And, you know, so many inspiring people have written so many really good books. And if you're not into reading books, just be yourself. Just be confident with the way you are. I think there's nothing like that, because it's very easy to look at someone and look at yourself and be like, shit, I'm like this, and look at that person. You know, but that person has their share of problems which they probably don't want to discuss.
Yeah.
Yeah. So understand where you are coming from, and understand and try to do what you can do from your side to be the best version. So and you have to, especially times like this, you have to stay connected to yourself. You need to know what's happening. You need to count your blessings. You have to be grateful. And you need to appreciate every single thing. Like, if the government is asking you to stay at home, then stay at home, because there will be a reason, right?
Yes.
So respect others, so that, you know, all small, small. It's all, like I said in the beginning, you make changes in small, small things, you'll see the result. You will see how beautiful your life is.
So there are a lot of people asking if you can suggest any good books. Do you have any book
if you start in
mind now?
Oh, I have. Alchemist, The Secret. That is a book that I would advise everybody to read.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that changed my life. So I think you should try that book. Mm. And I was not someone who used to read a lot of books. Okay, I don't have that patience. So what I would do is I would go to Pinterest or somewhere like that where you can read articles. I like reading articles. So if I see something about mental health, then I would like to read that article. If I see something about cooking, I would like to read it. So if I see an interesting topic that I like, I read about it. So you don't necessarily have to sit and read books and, you know, tell someone. That is also a problem, right? So if someone says, I like to read books, and someone who likes you will also try to read books, it's a good thing. It's a good habit, but you don't have to force yourself to read a book. If you like reading
something, when you meet a person or when you meet your friend, you talk about something. Not everyone talks about the negative side of whatever conversation you have, even though if you have experienced it. So do you think it's very important to embrace your negative emotion, or embrace good and bad emotions that you go through?
I would say it's important to embrace your emotions. There's no positive or negative. Just embrace it, right? Mm. So because the more you try to talk negative stuff, you attract more. That's something I learned from the book Secret. So the more you talk about it, the more you see only negativity around. But it's very important to, like, if you're feeling sad, feel sad. If you're feeling happy, be happy. If you're feeling angry, it's okay.
Yeah.
If you feel like jumping, just jump. It's completely fine. So it's okay to embrace your emotions, because it comes with you. So that's not something you can avoid. The more you avoid it, is when more you get depressed and become anxious, and it'll backfire. So you might as well as enjoy it, right? So if you feel like shouting, then shout, it's fine. So that all comes with, so if you know, people, they don't often show what they're going through, is because, like you said, they're scared of the judgment. Mm-hmm. They're scared of what people think about them. So if you can take up all those things and just be yourself by embracing your emotions and being real and being connected to yourself, there's nothing like that. I think that's the most beautiful thing.
That's amazing, Anjima. So is there anything else that you wanted to share which I have missed out in my questions?
No, I'm actually happy that you asked me to come live. You know, I've been thinking about this for a long time, but I
Yeah.
honestly, like I said, I was not in the mindset. So
Yeah.
that is one example. I was really not in a mindset. So when people ask me, I was a little scared of being, I mean, saying a no. But at the same time, I give importance to my emotions, my mental health. I am not ready to come live. So I don't want to come live yet. When I'm ready to come live, I'll 100% come. You know, but if I wanted to please someone, I would have gone live long back. Right, so that's what I said. It takes a little bit of courage to say no and stick to your what you feel is right. So I was just waiting, and then when you called me up, I thought, okay, this is the right time to talk about it, right? Because everybody's going through something or the other. So if I can talk a little bit about this and make at least 10 people happy, then why not? So I want to thank you for inviting me,
No, thank you
and
so
I'm
much. I'm
so
so glad
happy.
that you decided to do this, and I'm so happy that One Life was a platform for you to talk about so many good things. And
I think this
yeah,
is a
thank you
really
so
good
much.
platform. Please never stop this. Just please continue doing whatever you're doing
Of
right now.
course,
And I'm
of
glad I
course.
got to speak to my junior. I'm really proud
Yes,
right now.
you
So,
do.
yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pooja.
Thank you for your time, Manjima. So let's stay in touch. I'll meet you after all this lockdown is
Sure.
over. Yeah. Okay. So thank you so much for
Done.
your
Sure.
time. So thank
Thank
you.
you.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye. You too. Bye.